So should you get the new iPad Pro in 2019? Well, in this video, I'll be doing a quick review of what's new, what I like about it, what I use it for, what I don't like, and I recommend if you should buy one or not. So let's go ahead and hit that intro. Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Noah. If it's your first time here, I make videos on health, fitness, and tech to improve your life. If you haven't subscribed already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. So the new iPad Pro, what's new about it? Well, I will say the first thing is the screen size, and the reason being is because now the bezels are less. So it's actually, I have the 11 inch. It's the same size as 2017's 10.5 inch, but now the bezels around the screen are a lot thinner. So now you get a lot more screen space. So that also leads to the screen itself. It is the Liquid Retina display, which honestly just means that it's just fancier and has a lot more clarity. The colors are a lot more vibrant and it is just a nicer screen. The look and feel is also a little bit different. It's a little bit more modern and I think a little bit more futuristic looking. I have the space gray version and I really love the look and feel. Very, it's like thin but also solid at the same time. It also has the new Face ID function. So now instead of using your finger, there's no button on the front of the device. It's just the camera. So you can actually use the front facing camera to unlock your iPad. It also has a few different features like gestures and multitasking. You can have up to 3 apps open at the same time and you can just navigate it a lot different. Like there's a dock now at the bottom of the screen that you can swipe up and access your most recently used apps or the apps that you like to use the most. And it also now has the new charger, the USB-C, which is starting to become a little bit more popular now. Starting to become a little bit more mainstream. No more lightning connector, so if you have any old lightning connectors, it's not gonna work in here. And then on the back has a 12 megapixel camera, shoots 4K video, very clear, and I think it's like an 8 megapixel front facing camera. So very, they went all in on this device. And to be honest with you, I love this thing. This is like probably my favorite purchase of 2018, like by far, wouldn't return it. It's super small, it's powerful, it's fast, it's great for on the go usage, like, love this thing. Now, I use it for a couple things. The first main thing that I use it for is just taking notes. I have the keyboard case from Apple and I use it to take notes. In fact, for this video itself, I used it to take the notes for this video. And what's funny is I actually kind of use it like a director where when I'm making videos, I'm like, okay, this is the new topic. Great thing about the notes feature is that when you type notes on your iPad, it actually sends it over on the iCloud so I can have it on my iPhone. So I use like, you know, jot down ideas, thoughts, taking notes at like a conference or something like that. Very useful. Now the second thing I use it for is editing photos and videos on the go for social media, LinkedIn, YouTube, Instagram, just like short quick videos. The third main thing I use it for is actually client work. So my clients in the Body Confidence Academy, we have weekly check-in calls. So basically what I'll do is I'll take notes on here so I can see their progress, you know, how much weight they're losing, what they're eating, how much they're working out, and just taking notes on different goals that they may have. And then of course I use it for the normal media usage, YouTube, Netflix, streaming basketball and football games that are on. It's like very clear. It's like having like a mini TV in front of me and it's very useful. I can kick back on the couch and just good, prop it up on my knees. Finally, and I use it for reading. So I use my Kindle app. I also have a few of my study books on here for my certifications that I had. It's like reading a normal book, basically. You could just swipe and be good. Now, there are a few things I don't really like about the iPad Pro. Really, the main thing is that it's just not a full replacement for a computer. I know a lot of people have been asking that. No, it's not a full replacement. And the reason why I say that, it is powerful, but the OS is still something as of a tablet itself. This doesn't have a file system. Like I said, this is still under a tablet, so there's no desktop that you have. You can't have different folders. And what I really wish that they could do is you can't plug in like a USB or hard drive and put like different documents on here. The only thing you can really transfer by plugging in is photos and videos. But I think those would be my really only qualms about it. Now, I only have 2 accessories for the device, and that is the keyboard case from Apple and then the Apple Pencil 2. Basically, the case looks like this. It's magnetic, which is pretty interesting, and then clips on like so. So it's just like that, and that's how I usually kind of like type and you could swipe. So it kind of gives you like a computer feel, but it's not really a full computer. And then of course, the Apple Pencil, again, attaches magnetically. You've probably seen the commercial where they go like this, just like that. And it's pretty cool, but I would say that I think I just kind of got a little trigger happy and bought this because I was like, oh, let me buy the whole set. But I don't really use it too much. I might use it to write notes sometimes, but I would really recommend if you are like an artist or you love to draw or stuff like that, then I would get it if I were you. But other than that, save you like your 170 bucks. Now, do I recommend you buy this in 2019? So I would say buy it if you have like one of the older iPads. Like I upgraded from the iPad Air, which was like 4 or 5 years ago, back when I was like working at T-Mobile. And it was getting slow, it couldn't update, it couldn't do any of the multitasking. So that's why I upgraded. Or let's say that you are like an on-the-go creator, artist, or you like to work on like some Microsoft Office files, like PowerPoint or Excel or something like that, then say, yeah, like I would get it. But again, it's not a full replacement for your computer. So if that's what you're looking for, this is not it. But if you're looking for a kind of like a nice companion, I would say this works perfectly for that. Now, if you just wanna use it for a media device, like watching like YouTube videos, social media, and you know, web browsing, I would save your money and just buy like the 2018 iPad, or get the iPad mini, or if you want to, the 2017 iPad Pro is probably discounted as well. So you can't go wrong with that, but if you're just doing media usage, don't think it's just gonna be an expensive TV for you. So yeah, that is a quick wrap up about the iPad Pro and if you should get one in 2019. Let me know below, are you interested in getting an iPad Pro? Do you have one? What do you like? What do you don't like? Let me know in the comment box below. I hope this video was helpful for you. I'll catch y'all later. You already know, embrace the hype.